The head of the compliance department, Hubert Reynolds, says that the customs department usually takes the lead in goods entering the island. However, this time the Bureau of Standards have been able to identify fake goods because of grammatical errors and spelling on the labels. Reynolds was speaking after the International Police Organization seized fake goods worth nearly $60 million in a major operation across the Caribbean. Saint Lucia was one of those countries.
We have realized that those, and I'm going to refer to them as bargain traders, tend to be more non-conformities there. And the non-conforming items, including non-genuine items, we normally would discover them at those bargain retailers. And I would rather not identify in great detail who the bargain retailers are.
Interpol says car parts, fuel, food, detergent, shampoo and clothing were among some of the goods. The operation resulted in the closure of some companies.
I think it is. And like I said, the Bureau has already discovered items that are non-genuine. And so to say that there might be non-genuine items on the market, it's very likely.
The Bureau of Standards say that they cannot expose some of the traders who sell the fake goods. However, they are working with the Bureau to ensure that the goods stays off the market. For the DBS News World, I am Cecile Actille.